involved in an incident. It was a hate crime, it was a racist attack, and it was all about darkness and blood and pain. But these days, hopefully, I'm doing my street art gallery anti-violence project. I'm gathering all the artists and victims locally from Vancouver area, and we're putting together our efforts to have an artistic gallery happening in August 2010. And this is going to be a street art gallery, and we avoid to have it outdoors because we want it to be accessible to a diverse audience, specifically children, because whatever they learn, they will imitate, and they're going to be the next generation. A little bit of statistics to show the evidence that the awareness about the hidden violence happening in Vancouver has got an emergence in our community. Racialized groups in Canadian population are 16.2, and Vancouver by itself owns more than 200 different diverse communities. And 6 out of 10 police reported hate crimes in 2006 were related to race and ethnicity. A little bit about the anti-violence street art gallery. So there are true stories of victims that are going to be depicted by artists in different formats. Artists are going to contribute their art in different formats of sculpture, photography, performing arts, music, animation, and film. There are currently 13 victims on the list that are confidentially contributing their stories to us, and there are a team of about 15 artists that have joined the project for the next upcoming event that is going to be, that is estimated to be in August 2010. And the educational goal is the main point, so we're doing a lot of research to know about different researches that are done locally and in Canada, and also the educational brochures are designed and provided to the audience. The anti-violence project is going to be sustainable through the website, so in future, victims and artists will have the chance to sign up for the new projects. Some examples of the submitted projects are the canvas show, on-site painting with music and dance, some origami, express sport, education, story time, and etc. Where do our donations go? Number one, to supply, to provide art supplies to the artists. Number two, the second priority is the event organization in summer 2010. And number three, publishing educational brochures reflecting resources that are available to victims to raise awareness, to support, to provide information about available services, and to research statistics, true stories from the victims, and suggested solutions. And I would like to thank you for your time and ask if anyone has any questions about the project.
So we have 2 minutes for questions, so please ask away.